So what we're going to do from here is we're going to go through its music again, just because you know we're going to make sure that we know it. Oh gosh, so. So we're going to go through it once more. Well, we're going to count once more, go through it once more, and then I've got some things. Now we're fully warm, should be hot. Body and muscles should now be warm. We're going to go through two little techniques that you need to do when you're fully warm. So we're going to do one that's going to work on your leaps, and then two is just a bit of like stamina, getting your jump in and stuff like that. It's going to be a jump illusion sequence. But they're just here, I just wanted to do throw in just for a little bit of fun for you guys so that you can keep building up on your technique. So let's go through it again nice and slowly from the very top. Ready? We're going to miss out the wall because that's not part of the actual counted choreography. Ready? And then, what's my words? Thank you. Ready? 5, 6, 7, and we'll do 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4. We walk through. 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 7, 2, 3, 4, 8, 2, 3, 4. Good. Let's try all that through to music. Cool. Right then, so we're going to spend about 10-15 minutes just to end the lesson on our sequences. So, most of my classes do this. It's quite tough. Like, it's not tough, but you do feel the aches, the muscles. So, it's kind of fun, kind of not, depends how much you want to work. So, the first one that we're going to go straight into is your jump illusion sequence. And everything seems a bit more hot. And you'll be a bit more ready for the next one's sort of like a cool down one. So this one's very simple. It only has four movements, I think. I'm not too sure. So we'll start off with a jump illusion. So we do jump round here. Your first one is just going to be a step catch, and you're going to hold that leg. So you want to try and do it in four counts, but if you need eight, that's fine, or around six, I would say. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, okay? That's your first bit. The second part of it is, again, we're going round into a jump illusion. And then this time, we're going to go and hold it into a side catch, okay? So we're working on our front and our side catches there. But we're just adding a jump illusion into it, just to tighten that a little bit more, to keep that stamina going, to keep you remembering that even though there's things that are hard and you have to weigh yourself out, you still have to present ourselves in that hard core way. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. If I pop on some music,
I will count it through. Okay, let's do
when I dance now, which is a real shame. So it's been a long time since I've done one of those. Okay, so we're going to let the end of every single lesson. So hopefully, I'm out of breath by just doing one. That's how unfit I am these days, but it's fine. I am going to try and do them with you every single lesson, but I'm not going to cause injury to myself just yet. So I will be doing those with you as we go on and as we continue to do these online classes. So hopefully by the end of it, I'll improve a lot more by the time I've just done that one, because that one was awful. So yeah, we've done that. So just make sure that every single lesson you are giving it full speed, going it for as best you can, because the more you do them, the less out of breath you'll be and the more flexible you will become, because you're going from such a high jump and a high motion to something that's quite still and steady, so you're using lots of different muscles. Now, your second one is a lot more, you're stuck standing still, but you use a lot more muscle and a lot more energy actually. So make sure you're breathing for this, make sure you're listening to what I say, because you can hurt your back if you don't do it right. So grab a quick drink if you need to. Oh god, so I'm going to face my left palm because I'm using my right leg. If you prefer to use your left leg, you need to face this way. So just do everything opposite to what I'm doing. So this is working on our leap. So we're basically breaking down our leap. And to do that, we're going to work on your front leg. So if you leap with your right leg in front, face the same way as me. So it's towards your left, so your right leg is in front of you. If you leap with your left leg forwards, you need to face towards your right with your left leg facing in front of you. Okay? And then move all the way back. The sun's come down.
I'm going to move the camera here.
So if you're facing my way, which is my right leg in front, your right hand comes out in front of you, and your left hand comes up vertically into an L shape, okay? So you should be like this, okay? If you're leaving the left leg in front, again, you want to have your left arm out and your right in an L shape, so it should be like this, okay? Here. So everything you do for the first time, your hands come here. So the first thing we do is we bring up our leg in a very, very slight bend. It's more of an attitude, okay? So we hit here for one. We're here, okay? We're then gonna shoot our leg all the way up, but we're keeping it bent in the attitude position. As you keep it bent, you take your arm to the next level here, okay? So I'm here, here. If I'm right leg, I'm here. Here, here. Now, I don't mind how hard you get that leg. I would rather it here and here and you be in control than all the way up here and you not. So just again, we're working through the stages of a leap. So we've got one, two, hit three, four. As you do this, please, please, please keep in mind that we're learning to leap. Therefore, when you leap, your head instantly should turn. Okay, open up the fall. So if I'm leaping, I'm gonna hit this position here with my head, okay? So that's exactly what we're gonna do. We're gonna keep everything the same, but we're not jumping, okay? So we're hitting here, 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 okay? So we've got one, two, three, four, okay? The next bit, we lower down for four. So we should be here, we lower one, two, three, four. Your arms come back to normal. From here, we're taking it up again to the first level, one, two. So everything on the first level is bent, okay? Feet, one, two. From here, we're doing a flick, okay? So you get your développé leap and you get your flick leap, both are two different. So your développé is a brush on the floor, so your legs stay straight. Your flick is an extension from the knee. So we're gonna do the extension from the knee. So we're here, we flick up, here, okay? It is very, very hard to keep that momentum and stay there, and I fall quite quick, so don't worry if you do. So we've got, there's the first two, we do 1, 2, 3, 4, lower, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, flick, 3, 4, lower, 2, 3, 4. Got it? Should I focus on a little bit more? Yeah. Ready? 5. From the top, 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 4, lower, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, lower, 2, 3, 4. Good. Got two more, no, one more to go. Have we? Yeah. From here, we are going into a full rise. You can't even see me, can you? Sorry about this. You're going into your full rise. So, you've done hip, hip, lower, hip, flick, lower. From here, we'll go back into a flick. But the difference with this one is our supporting leg on the floor is going into a rise. So you're getting that motion to take it off in the air. So if I've just done my flick, lower, 2, 3, 4, I hit 1, 2, rise, lower. Okay? I do not want to see your, obviously when you lean naturally, you arch ever so slightly with that back, but I don't want to see this to keep your position. I don't want to see you hunched. I want to see a nice straight line, shoulders back, chest out, arms up, over. Okay? Let's go all the way from the top and we'll go to music. Ready? 5, 6, 7, and we do 1, 2, 3, 4, lower, 2, 3, 4. Now 1, 2, flick, lower, 2, 3, and 1, 2, rise, lower, 2, 3, 4. Good. The last little bit from here, it's very, very simple. I'm going to do it this way so you can see my leg. So if you've lowered, you then step forward on the leg and up. So whichever leg is in front, you're going to transfer onto. So if you're doing it to the right like me, and you've just done all your legs on this leg, you're going to transfer the weight onto that leg. If you've just done it all on the left leg, and you've just been doing all of it on the left, you're going to transfer onto the left. Because I'm either on my right, I'm going to transfer to my right, and you wait. I'll tell you when to go, because it goes to the music. You then lift up for four counts. So your hands are going to either come out horizontally or they're going to come out into an L shape, okay? I'm going to go out into an L shape just because I do it naturally. So you're going to rise. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now what I don't want to see is this. I do not want to see you lifting your leg into an arabesque with your back. The arabesque has to come from the leg. You have to work the leg, not the back. You will damage your back if you take it up with the back. So if I'm taking my leg up, all the power is coming from my back, you're going to get a lot of strain here. So you want to make sure that all the weight from this movement is coming from the leg. So my back should tilt forward just a tad, but I can't get my leg really high towards the back, but I know I'm not damaging anything, so it's fine. But if I'm doing this, I'm taking all the weight in my back when I should have been. And arabesque comes from the legs. So please, please, please keep your back nice and straight. So you want to hit 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? Do not lean that back over. From here, you bounce. 1, 2, 3, 4. They need to be obvious bounces. They don't want to see this. They need to be nice and big bounces like that. You're working all of this muscle here. You should get two bounces in my one count, okay? So you've got it for 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. We lower 1, 2, 3, 4. Please, please, please take your time to lower for the four count. It's going to stretch out all the muscles in your back. If you go from here, bounce, and then go, you're going to cause a bit of pain here. So just make sure you're lowering nice and steady just to stretch out all the back muscles. Another thing that I will say, what was I going to mention? Can't remember what I was going to mention. Yeah, just take your time. Don't force your leg up as much as you can. I'd rather like me keep it low and work it properly. Because a leap, what I have found is a leap does come from your back as well. So the back muscles encourage your legs in your leap. So it's really important that this exercise especially is working all that back muscle. It's also working your back leg and your leap. So the front bit that we do is working your front leg. This part we do is supporting that back leg. So by the time we finish these online classes, your legs should be nice and straight if you're doing it correctly.
Let's try it all through to music and see how we get on.
Is she the one? The one you've been waiting for. Is she the one? Is she the one? The one you've been dreaming of. Is she the one? I'm tired of staying up all night with you on my mind. Still I'm in here. Yeah, I'm laying in the shirt you used to like. No, I shouldn't mind. All I think about is, does she move your body like I moved your body? Cause I wanna know, yeah, I wanna know. Does she make you feel wanted? Is she all you want?
Please make sure you are doing those properly because you will see a massive, massive difference. A lot of my classes have only been doing it for a few weeks, but their leaps are changing drastically. So it definitely works. Please keep it up. Got any questions, please pop it on the WhatsApp chat. I'm more than happy to help you. But yeah, hopefully you've enjoyed today's lesson with me. And we'll be back again for some more choreo. See you all later. Bye.